Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Jaya Giri Varadhari Jaya Giri Varadhari Yashoda Nandana Jayo Braja Jana Ranjana Jayo Braja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Tiravana Chari Jayo Kunja Bihari Jayo Yamuna Tiravana Chari Jayo Kunja Bihari Jayo Radha Madhava Jayo Kunja Bihari Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Jayo Giri Varadhari Jayo Giri Varadhari Yashoda Nandana Jayo Braja Jana Ranjana Jayo Braja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Tiravana Chari Jayo Kunja Bihari Jayo Radha Madhava Jayo Kunja Bihari Jayo Radha Madhava Jayo Kunja Bihari Jayo Radha Madhava Jayo Kunja Bihari
Jayam Vishnu Pada Paramahams Parivrajaka Acharya Shtutvacharishyam Dabhai Charanari Bhuttivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai Jayam Vishnupad Paramhams Parivrajaga Acharya Shtutar Sashrimad Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada Ki Jai Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda Ki Jai Namacharya Shri Hridas Thakur Ki Jai Prem Se Kaho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavrinda Ki Jai Shri Shri Radha Shri Govardhan Ki Jai 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 Shri Govardhan गोवर्धन की जय। ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय। पुरुषोत्तम क्षेत्र जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। गंगा माई की जय। जमुना माई की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। श्रीमती तुलसी महारानी की जय। सामवेद गौर भक्तवृंद की जय। ताय गौर प्रेमानंदी हरि हरि बोल। All glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories, all glories, all glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Hare Krishna. Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 27, Text 30-31. Chandanoshir Karpura Kumanguru Vashitaihi Salilai Snapayen Mantrair Nityada Vibhavesati चंदनोशीर कर्पूर कुंकुमांगुरु वासितैः सलिलै स्नापयेन मंत्रैः नित्यदा विभवेसति। चंदनोशीर कर्पूर कुंकुमांगुरु वासितैः सलिलै स्नापयेन मंत्रैः नित्यदा विभवेसति। Matajis. Chandana with sandalwood paste. Ushira, the fragrant ushira root. Karpura, camphor. Kunkuma, vermilion. Aguru, aloes wood. Vasitaihi, which are perfumed. Salilaihi, by different kinds of water. Snapayet, one should bathe the deity. Mantraihi, with mantras. Nityada, every day. Vibhave, assets, sati, to the extent that there are. Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. The worshipper should bathe the deity every day as opulently as his assets permit, using waters scented with sandalwood, ushira root, camphor, kumkuma, and aguru. He should also chant various Vedic hymns such as Anuvak, known as Swarna Gharma, the Mahapurush Vidya, the Purusha Shukta, and various songs of the Samaveda such as Rajan and Rohinya. Purport. The Purush Shukta prayer beginning Om Sahasra Shirsha Purusha Sahasraksha Sahasrapat is contained within the Rig Veda. Om Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuron Militam Yena Tasmay Shri Guruve Namaha श्री चैतन्य मनोभिष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वापदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरोन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातान् सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणा ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचना गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामी नितिनामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासदि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा सीकिंग ब्लेसिंग्स फ्रॉम ऑल द डिवोटीज assembled here so that we can speak something for our own purification. So we are discussing from the 11th canto, 27th chapter, the process of deity worship. And in this verse, Krishna is explaining the details of how one should bathe the deity of the Lord. And one important word which Krishna uses in this verse is Nityada Vibhave Sati. Every day, one should bathe the deity of the Lord as opulently as his assets permit. So today we'll be discussing on this word Vibhave Sati, you know, as opulently as his assets permit. You know. So that means to the best of one's capacity. So Krishna always wants his devotees to give their best, you know, according to the devotee's capacity. So that is what Krishna expects from everyone, all the devotees. We have to give our best to Krishna. We have to take inspiration from other devotees and we don't have to compare with others out of enviousness. We can see other devotees excelling in devotional services and we can take inspiration so that we can also give our best. You know, we see in Bhagavatam, there are two places where the word comes aham purvam, aham purvam. So first it comes in the Vrajalila where Krishna is going to the forest with all the cowherd boys and they are herding the calves and the cows. So they are playing lots of games. And one game they play is when Krishna goes far in the forest, so all the other cowherd boys, they try to run towards Krishna and their competition is who will touch Krishna first. Yadi dure gatam Krishna vano shobhekshanayanah aham purvam aham purvam iti samsprishyare mire. Yadi dure gatam Krishna, if Krishna goes far away in the forest to see the beauty of the forest, vano shobhekshanayanah. So what does all the other cowherd boys they do? Aham purvam aham purvam, they also run saying, I will touch Krishna first, I will touch Krishna first. Iti samsprishya remire. So acharyas, they give the mood behind this competition. They tell the gopas, they want to run faster because they want to inspire other gopas so that he can run fast and he will touch Krishna first. You know, one time His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj, he was talking about book distribution in our temple here. And he was saying that we should try to give our best in this book distribution, but we should not come first, you know.
So that is the mood of all the devotees. We should give our best to Krishna, but it should not be in the mood of defeating others. We should try to take inspiration and give our best. And in contrast to this, another place where this word comes, aham purvam is in Samudra Manthan Leela. When all the demons, they have churned the ocean of the milk and the nectar comes out. So one of the demon grabs the nectar from the hands of Dhanvantri and he starts running. So all the demons, they start fighting amongst each other, you know. Mithah kalir abhut tesham tadarthe tarsh chetasam aham purvam natvam natvam iti prabho. You know, mithak kali, they started fighting among themselves. Tadarthe, for the sake of nectar. Tarsh chetasam, they wanted to get that nectar. And then what they were saying, aham purvam, I will drink nectar first. Natvam, natvam, not you, you know. So that is the difference between competition of a devotee and the outsider's competition. You know, we have to give our best, taking inspiration from Krishna. And the other devotees, how Krishna wants to see devotees to excel according to their capacity, and seeing other devotees how they are serving so nicely. You know, so one devotee was saying in a very jolly mood that Krishna is a very jealous God. You know, he wants the best out of us. Krishna does not want anything less than the best from a devotee. So, and we should understand that this demand is not for Krishna's benefit, it is for our benefit. When we are giving our best to Krishna, Krishna is not getting benefited. He has everything. He is not in dearth of servants in spiritual world. Are, Golok mein kami ho gaya, thoda yahan se bulana padega. No. There are lots of Lakshmis, sahasra sahasra Lakshmis, they are serving, gopis. They are ready to serve. He is not in dearth of any servants. It is we who are in need of giving service. One of the verse comes in Bhagavatam, it is described, Tatropanit balayo raver deepam ivadrita atma ramam purnakamam nijalabhena nityada. So when Krishna enters Dwarka from Hastinapur, so all the Dwarka Vasis, they bring various gifts. So Sut Goswami says that they were giving whatever was given to them by Krishna only. Just like raver deepam ivadritaha. When you worship sun, what do? We offer a lamp to sun. You know, sun is not in need of any light. So it is the mood of the worshipper which the sun is accepting. Because Lord is Atma Ram and Purnakam. He is self-satisfied. He does not need anything. So then why does the devotee offer? Nij labhena. For his own benefit, for his own purification, one should offer everything to Krishna. You know, so when we offer things to Krishna, it gets purified. You know, Bhagavatam describes how various things are purified. Kalen snana sauchabhyam samskare stapasejaya shuddhyanti danai santushtya dravyani atmatma vidya. In due course of time, all the immovable things, the mountains, the trees, they get purified, they get cleansed. Snan, by taking bath, the body gets purified. Samskar, by the process of samskaras, the birth gets purified. Tapasa, the elements of the body gets purified by tapasya. Ijaya, when we offer things to Krishna, the articles get purified. Shuddhyanti danai, and the wealth gets purified by charity. Santushtya, mind gets purified by being satisfied. And Atma, Atma Vidya, the soul gets purified by the Atma Vidya. So when we offer things to Krishna, we get purified and the things get purified, you know. So therefore, Krishna likes to put his devotees sometimes in difficult situations so that they'll be forced to give their best, you know. One of the verses describes the beauty of the Lord. Snigdha pravrid ghanashyamam sarva saundarya sangraham charuvayata chaturbahu sujata ruchirananam. Snigdha pravrid ghanashyamam. Krishna is very, very beautiful, blackish complexion. Sarva saundarya sangraham. He is the abode of all the beauty. And the best part of his beauty is, he likes to give credit to his devotees. he does not take any credit to him for himself, and he likes to give all credit to his devotees. He wants to take the best out of his devotees. So that is how Lord is so very eager to see his devotees giving their best, you know. One time, one devotee, Prabhupada disciple, Patit Uddharan Prabhu, he went to Prabhupada and he said, Prabhupada, we all are eager to hear what will please you the most. You know, there are so many services which are dear to you, but we want to know which is the best service, which of the services you like the most, and what is most dear to you. Prabhupada said, no, when you chant Hare Krishna and you serve the Lord, you become simply wonderful. That is what is pleasing to me, you know. So that's how Krishna wants to put his devotees in some conditions where they will be forced to give their best, you know. And there are so many instances in Bhagavatam where devotees are put in some difficult situations and their best came out, you know. In first canto, when Ashwatthama killed all the 5 sons of Draupadi, so Arjuna took a vow, I will bring the head of Ashwatthama and Draupadi can stand on that head and take bath. In that way, she will be satisfied. So he goes and he arrests Ashwatthama, but he does not kill him because he is a Brahmana. He brings it back, brings the Ashwatthama back, and then there is an argument which happens. Draupadi says, don't kill him because he is a son of a Brahmana. He is our son of our teacher. He is not supposed to be killed. Krishna says, no, he is killer of your children. He should be killed. Yudhishthira Maharaj says, no, I think whatever Draupadi is saying is right. Bhima says, no, you have to kill him. You know, Nakula Sahadev goes to the side of Yudhishthira Maharaj. So then Arjuna is in an utter confusion. So many devotees are giving different opinions. Krishna is saying then, you know, you have to satisfy Draupadi also because you have made a vow. You have to satisfy Bhima also. You have to satisfy me also, you know. And then Arjuna, because he was such a devoted and such a surrendered soul, Krishna inspires him. Arjuna sahasa agyaya harer hardam athasina. Arjuna knew the heart of Krishna. Therefore, he could do the right thing. He gave his best response. What did he do? He did not kill Ashwatthama. He just cut off the money jewel which was there on the head of Ashwatthama and the hair of Ashwatthama. So that is the right punishment for a Brahmana, you know. Kunti Maharani prays in, you know, her prayers, after so many calamities which came in the life of Kunti Maharani, she is saying, I want more troubles to come. Vipada santuta shashwat. Because she says that when troubles will come in our lives, you will come. Bhavato darshanam yat syat apunar bhava darshanam. And if we take your darshan, we will not have to take darshan of this world again. You know? So that is the best response Kunti Maharani is making, you know. And then again in first canto, Krishna bewilders Yudhishthir Maharaj. He could convince Arjuna to fight, but Krishna could not convince Yudhishthira Maharaj. Yudhishthira Maharaj was under utter guilty consciousness. After the whole battle of Kurukshetra, Yudhishthira Maharaj was thinking, I am responsible for all this. And everybody tried to pacify him, but he could not be pacified, you know. So one of the words which is used by Sut Goswami is Krishnena Adbhut Karmana. What was the adbhut karma of Krishna? He bewildered Yudhishthira Maharaj and he did not allow his instructions to be followed by Yudhishthira Maharaj. Krishna, as super soul in the heart of Yudhishthira Maharaj, did not allow Yudhishthira Maharaj to hear the instructions which he was giving. That is the adbhut karma of Krishna. And why did he do that? So that Yudhishthira Maharaj could go to Bhishma, who was lying on the bed of arrows, and he could give his best response, you know. The best instructions were given by Bhishma Dev on that bed of arrows, you know. And the whole Bhishma Parva is one of the biggest, you know, parts of Mahabharata, which describes the detail of all the instructions. You know, Dan Dharman, Raj Dharman, Moksha Dharman, Vibhagashah, Stri Dharman, Bhagavat Dharman, Samas Vyasa Yogata. So he described so many instructions, you know. So that was how Yudhishthira Maharaj was put into bewilderment so that Bhishma could give his best response. Parikshit Maharaj was put into so many difficulties. He was cursed to die in 7 days, but he did not become any less morose. All the more he became very eager, all the more he became intense in his devotional consciousness. And he says, he leaves everything, goes to the bank of the Ganga, and he prays to all the sages, you know, that, O sages, if the death has to come, and whatever the mystic bird that Brahmana has created, let it come. You please keep on singing the glories of Lord Vishnu, you know. Tamopayatam pratiyantu vipra ganga cha devi dhrita chittamishe dijopasrishtam kohakastakshakova dashatvalam gayata vishnu gatha. So this is how all the devotees, you know, Vidura, you know, when he is chastised and blamed and criticized by Duryodhan, what does he do? He takes it as the mercy of the Lord. He leaves his bow and arrow on the door of the palace and he goes for the, you know, Tirtha Yatra. You know. We see in the fourth canto also, Prithu Maharaj, when there was so much of, you know, confusion and so much of conflict which was happening between Prithu Maharaj and Indra, so Lord Vishnu comes and Brahma comes, and Lord Vishnu is pleased by the qualities of Prithu Maharaj. So Lord Vishnu, he tells Prithu Maharaj that I am very, very pleased by your qualities and your devotion. I am controlled by your devotion. You know, please ask me whatever you want. You know. So then the best response of Prithu Maharaj came out. You know, if Krishna comes in front and you know asks, what's Vardhan Mango? You know, so our list may be ready. You know, ye chahiye. But what is the best response a devotee gives? Prithu Maharaj, what he says? Na kama yena tadapyaham kochin nayatra yushmat charanambuja savaha mahattamaikantaridayan mukhachyuto vidhatsvakarna yuta eshamevaraha. He says, na kama yena, O my Lord, I do not want liberation. I do not want to go to any place where there is no service to you. What do I want? I want millions of years. Why? So that I can keep on hearing your glories. I want to keep on serving you and I want to keep on hearing your glories. That is the response which Prithu Maharaj gives. Vritrasur, after he is cursed, after Chitraketu Maharaj cursed to become Vritrasur, and as he is being killed by Indra, the best response comes out in the form of beautiful, beautiful prayers. Only 4 verses are there, Vritrasur prayers. But those 4 prayers are choicest poetries, you know. So that is how Krishna likes to put his difficulties in some difficult situations and put his difficulties, his devotees into difficulties so that they can give their best. And also Krishna sometimes give his devotees everything to test them, you know. Just like Dhruva Maharaj, when he saw darshan of Lord Vishnu, and you know, Lord Vishnu said, "Oh Dhruva, you have pleased me. Please ask." So Dhruva Maharaj says, "I am satisfied. Swamin kritarthosmi varam nayache. I was looking for broken pieces of glass, but what I have got is diamond." You know, and after, he goes to rule his kingdom, and then the whole story goes how his brother Uttama is killed, and then Dhruva Maharaj starts killing all the yakshas. Then the head of yakshas, Kuvera, comes, and then Swayambhuva Manu comes. Then first Swayambhuva Manu comes and he instructs Dhruva that, "Oh Dhruva, this is not the right way. For just one yaksha you are killing whole dynasty of yakshas. You should not do this." So he stops killing them. Seeing this, Kuvera becomes so happy. Kuvera comes and he, you know, expresses his joy to Dhruva Maharaj. And he says, "Ask whatever you want." You know, Kuvera is the king of all the treasury. He is the treasurer of heaven. He can give any amount of wealth. So when he is telling Dhruva, "Ask whatever you want. I am ready to give anything." So then what does Dhruva says? सराज राजे नवराय चोदितो ध्रुवो महाभागवतो महामति हरौ सवव्रे चलितां स्मृतिं ययौ तरत्य यत्नेन दुरत्ययं तमः. सो दिस राज राजेन ध्रुव महाराज व्हेन ही वाज आस्क्ड प्लीज आस्क फॉर बेनेडिक्शन. सो ध्रुवा बिकॉज ही वाज महाभागवत एंड ही वाज महामति ही वाज अ ग्रेट डिवोटी ऑफ द लॉर्ड. सो व्हाट डिड ही आस्क? ही आस्क्ड हरौ सवव्रे अचलिताम स्मृति. प्लीज गिव मी अनफ्लिंचिंग फेथ एंड रिमेम्बरेंस ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड. यू नो सो बिकॉज बाई दैट आई विल क्रॉस दिस ओशन ऑफ मटेरियल एग्जिस्टेंस. यू नो प्रहलाद महाराज व्हेन ही वाज आस्क्ड बाई नरसिम्हदेव प्लीज आस्क फॉर बेनेडिक्शन. यू नो आचार्य से टिल नाउ Narasimhadev was angry. When Prahlad Maharaj heard this from Narasimhadev, he became angry on Narasimhadev, you know. And then he says, "Oh Lord, I have not done devotional service to do a business with you. I am not a vanik. I am not a businessman. I have just performed my bhakti to please you." You know. So there are so many instances. Krishna puts his devotees into troubles and he puts his devotees into opulences to test them. You know, Prabhupada also said, Krishna tested me twice. First by taking away everything from me, and then by giving everything to me. And in both circumstances, he was equipoised, you know. So as the Lord wants to give credit to his devotees, you know, devotees also want to give credit to other devotees. Prabhupada would always give credit to his disciples. He never took any credit to himself, you know. One time Tamal Krishna Goswami, he was asking Prabhupada, how many pure devotees are there on this planet? So Prabhupada asked one of the devotees, how many devotees are there in ISKCON? So somebody said, 700 Prabhupada. So Prabhupada said, there are 700 pure devotees in this world, you know. So Prabhupada was always eager to give credit to others, always encouraging devotees, you know. And he was very humble, you know. He always demystified things about himself. One time, one devotee, Chit Sukhanand Prabhu, he was sharing that he was in Mexico with Prabhupada and they were sitting on the top of a building and it was a very, very nice sunset. And he was sitting like a small puppy, he was saying, you know, besides Prabhupada. And then as sun was setting, he saw some mosquitoes started hovering over Prabhupada and started biting him also. But then he saw that mosquitoes are not biting Prabhupada. So he asked, Prabhupada, it looks that, you know, they are not biting you. So it seems that because you are a pure devotee, that's why they are not biting you, you know. Prabhupada said, that may be the case, but in Calcutta, they don't make any distinction, you know. So he always demystified things about himself, you know. One time, Revati Nandan Prabhu, one of the disciples, he was sharing that, you know, many people, they speculate about Prabhupada's past life. Who was Prabhupada in his past life, you know? So one time in Calcutta, Prabhupada himself said, you know, that, you know, in my previous life, I was a doctor and I lived a sinless life. That's why in this life, I could perform devotional service so seriously. And then he said, you know, it took me 30 years to chant purely, you know. So Prabhupada was always a pure devotee, but out of his humility, you know, he always made such statements so that, you know, nobody can think himself to be from some other plane. But by his actions, he showed that he was not of this world, you know. So another question may come, why Krishna puts devotees into all these things, in troubles or in opulences? That is only for one reason, you know, to increase our intensity and eagerness for Krishna, you know. In the morning, just I was listening one of the classes, and you know, our Anand Vrindavan Prabhu, he was asking a question. He said, and it was a very, very relevant question. He said, Prabhuji said that, you know, in this material world, people try to get sense gratification and they try so many ways, but at the end, they get frustrated, you know, because they cannot get sense gratification. And in spiritual life also, we are trying to get that Krishna prema. We are also struggling day in and day out. Sola mala kar rahe hai, we are serving, struggling, following principles. But what if after a long time, we don't get Krishna prema, you know? And we will also get frustrated. So how to see, matlab, he says, you know, how to make sure that, you know, we don't get frustrated in the long run. So Maharaj gave a very, you know, wonderful answer. He said, it will happen for sure. We will get frustrated if we are not eager and if we are not endeavoring to the best of our capacity to please Krishna, you know. Because the nature of this world is, in this world, the river flows downstream. By nature, this world pulls us down. And if we are not struggling enough, endeavoring enough, then for sure we will also get trapped by the material energy, you know. So we should also have that eagerness and enthusiasm to keep struggling, you know. Once one person came to Prabhupada and said, Swamiji, you know, you will save me, you can enlighten me. Prabhupada said, no, I cannot enlighten you. I can tell you how you can become enlightened yourself, you know. But you have to do the work. Prabhupada once wrote a letter to Sarup Damodar Goswami, Sat Sarup Das Goswami Maharaj. And he was saying, giving an analogy. He was saying that just like when the birds, they fly in a formation, the formation helps them to fly long distances. But if one bird is weak and cannot fly, other birds will not help that bird. What will happen to that bird? The bird will fall down. So for sure, association of devotees help us. They guide us, they inspire us, but we have to do our chanting. Nobody can chant for us, you know, Mera Sola Mala bhi aap kar lo. That may not be, that is not possible. So we have to become personally strong so that we can be in association of devotees and get enlightened, you know. As Rupa Goswami says, Krishna Bhakti Rasa Bhavita Mati Kriyatam Yadi Kutopi Labhyate Tatra Laulyam Api Mulyam Ekalam Janma Koti Sukritir Nalabhyate. If you want that Krishna Bhakti Rasa, after all, whatever we are doing, struggling so hard, taking care of the family, going to office, doing so many services, coming to temple, chanting, getting up in the morning, why we are struggling so much? To get that Krishna Bhakti Rasa. We have tasted a little bit, everybody of us have tasted something, some drop, you know, sometimes, in some festival, in some katha, some yatra. So we have little experience of this. That Krishna Bhakti Rasa, Rupa Goswami is saying, Kriyatam Yadi Kutopi Labhyate, Jahan Kahi Bhi Mil Raha Hai Kharid Lijiye, you know. Wherever it is available, you buy it. But to buy, you have to pay a price. What is the price we have to pay to get that Krishna Bhakti Rasa? Tatra Laulyam Api Mulyam. Only price we have to pay is, we have to be eager about it. We have to want it. If you don't want that bhakti rasa, we will not get it, you know. So that is the price we have to pay. We have to be eager. We have to be eager to follow the rules and regulations, to develop a taste for the sadhana bhakti, that five limbs of bhakti, reading Bhagavatam, you know. We have to develop that taste. You know? We have to be eager about it. And when we get that taste, you know, three things happen. First, the devotee becomes joyful. The things and troubles of this world will not disturb us. Krishna Pada Padma Gandha Jai Jana Pai Brahma Loka Adi Sukhat Tare Nahi Bhai. Whoever has got the little nectar of this Krishna Bhakti Rasa, a drop of this nectar, he is not disturbed by the problems of this world and is not disturbed by the pleasure of this world, you know. And when we become absorbed in bhakti, we become serious, we also become blissful, you know. And we also, and we have seen devotees, they come, they become so serious, start chanting 16 rounds, take initiation, and they become very, very serious because they have tasted some joy, you know. One time one devotee was taking initiation by Radhana Swami Maharaj, and Maharaj gave him name Varuttapa Das. So he was confused. Iska matlab kya hota hai? Ye Varuttapa ka matlab kya hai? So he went on asking different devotees. Kya matlab hai? So nobody knew. That is long back, you know. 95, 96, that time. So he went to our Sudama Prabhu. You know. So Sudama Prabhu se pucha, Prabhu ji, iska matlab kya hai? Varuttapa Das. So he'll bole, Sudama Prabhu said, hey, Varuttapa nahi hai, Varantup Das hai, you know. सो बोले महाराज को मालूम है तुमको वरन तूप पसंद है इसलिए तुम्हारा नाम वरुत्तपा दिया है वरन तूप दास दिया है यू नो सो ही बिकेम ऑल द मोर बिविल्डर्ड एंड देन समबडी टोल्ड हिम एक्चुअली वरुत्तपा इज अ गोपा फ्रेंड ऑफ कृष्णा यू नो सो एज वी बिकम सीरियस इन कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस वी ऑल्सो बिकम जॉयफुल सेकेंड थिंग विच हैपन्स इज वी डू नॉट एस्पायर फॉर एनीथिंग अपार्ट फ्रॉम भक्ति यू नो नॉट इवन लिबरेशन which is aspired for by most of the people in this world. Mukti chahiye, you know, is sansar ke kashton se mukti. Devotee does not want that also. One time, you know, Rup Goswami says in Padyavali, one time Mukti Devi personified, she comes to a devotee and this devotee is doing his chanting, mala kar raha hai, aag band karke, you know. So Mukti Mataji comes, you know, and Mukti Devi is standing and all of a sudden, this devotee understands that somebody has come. So he opens his eyes and he gets shocked. Who is this? So he asks, Katvam, who are you? So Mukti Devi says, Mukti Rupagatasmi Bhavati. I am Mukti Devi, I have come to you. So devotee says, Kasmad Akasmadiha. How come suddenly you have come? I did not call for you. So Mukti Devi says, you know, she says that, Tvam Krishna Deva Smaranena Bhavato Dasi Padam Prapita. Because you are serving Krishna, I have become your Dasi. So, devotee becomes angry. He says, Duretisht Managanagasi. Oh, abominable one, stay away. So, Mukti Devi becomes surprised. Are? Kasmat, she says, you know, that Katham Kuryad Anaryam Mai. Are, what wrong I have done? I have come to serve you and you are giving me gali, you know. So why you are doing such way, behaving in such way? So he says, Tvat gandha nij naam chandan rasa lepasya lopo bhavet. Just by the smell of your body, you know, just by being near you, my taste for bhakti will go away, you know. So devotee is not interested in anything of this world. You know, generally people in this world, they want shanti, 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 you know. But devotee is not after shanti, they are interested in seva. When the seva, and for seva, they are ready to take all anxieties. You know. And in that seva, then anxiety of the seva, the devotee becomes happy. You know, tomara sevaya dukkha hoye, seo to parama sukha. Seva sukha dukkha parama sampada nashaye avidya dukkha. Because the pains we experience in the process of serving the Lord destroys our ignorance of Krishna. You know. And third thing which happens is devotees, they become fearless. For an outsider, death is a very, very miserable and dreadful experience. You know, but for a devotee, it is not such a dreadful and fearful experience. And an example is given just like a cat when catches the kitten. For a kitten, it is a very, very wonderful, soothing experience of an embrace of a mother. But for a rat, it is a death personified. Similarly, for a devotee, he is not fearful of death. Chakravarti Pad writes that, you know, for a devotee, for a non-devotee, death is like an arranged marriage. You know, for a girl, she does not know what is going to happen. You know, who will be my husband and in-laws? So she is in fear. But for a devotee, death is like a love marriage. You know, because the lady already knows where she is going, who will be her husband, her in-laws. So she is happy, you know. She is anticipating to go to that place, you know. So that's why the devotees, they are not fearful. Because, you know, as in this Ajamila pastime, Yamraj describes, he tells whom to bring, you know, who will go to the abode of Yamraj. Yamraj tells to Yamdutas, Jihvana Vakti Bhagavad Gunnam Adheyam Chetaschana smartita charanar vindam Krishnaya no namati ashire kadapi tananayadvam asato akrit vishnu krityan Jihuana vakti. Kisko leke aaye mere paas? Whoever does not take the name of Krishna, Bhagavad gun nam adhyam, bring me those people. Chetaschana smarti, those who do not remember Krishna, bring those people. Krishnaya no namati ashire. Those who do not offer obeisances to Krishna, bring those people. Do not bring the devotees of Lord. because they are always protected by the Gada of Lord Vishnu. You know, Gadaya Bhigupta, they are protected by the Lord, you know. And that's why devotees are fearless. So to maintain and increase the eagerness, we should do some things. First thing we can do is, we can hear about the eagerness and the enthusiasm of our predecessor acharyas and the current devotees. We see some of the devotees are very, very eager to hear Krishna Katha, the way they chant, the way they do services, always eager, you know. We have to hear about them. That increases our eagerness, our aspirations to serve. And we have to see and hear the eagerness of the devotees of Lord Chaitanya and the devotees from Bhagavatam. Just like Raghunath Das Goswami, you know. He was so eager to go to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had to tell him, Sirhaiya gharayao naho batul krame krame paye lok bhava sindukul. You know, be steady, don't become mad, you know. Sthir ho jao, you know. Ghar jao, aram se raho, you know. In due course, you will come to me, you know. And in due course, he definitely ran away to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Grame grame pata chhadi jaye vane vane kaye mano vakye chintye Chaitanya charane. So he was running through the forest path because from the main path, his father's servants and the soldiers would come and they would catch him again. He was always thinking of meeting Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know. Shri Chaitanya Nityananda Charane Chintiya Pata Chhadi Upapathe Jayana Dhaiya. Always remembering the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya, he was running through the forest. That's how he was eager, you know. As Rukmini Devi, she expresses her eagerness in her letter to Krishna. She says, "Oh my Lord, if I don't get you in this life, you know, I am ready to give up my life and take birth again and do tapasya again, again give up my life, and in this way I am going to do for hundreds of lifetimes. I am ready for this. Yasyangri pankaja rajasnapanam mahanto vanchantyuma patirivatmatamopahatyai yarhi ambujakshana labhe abhavat prasadam jahyana shunavrat krishan shatajanma bhisyat. You know, yasya angri pankaja, if I don't get your lotus feet, oh my Lord, vanchanti umapati ivatma, that lotus feet is desired even by Lord Shiva. If I don't get those lotus feet, I am ready to give up my life for hundreds of lifetimes. You know, that's how she was eager. And Prabhupada said once to one devotee that you become sincere. Somebody asked, how you become sincere, you know? How we should be sincere in Krishna consciousness? Prabhupada said, you have to want it. I want to become sincere. I want this Krishna consciousness. I want to surrender. Unless we want it, we will not get it. You know? So, you know, serious and being sincere does not mean we should always have a stern look. You know, bilkul hasna hi nahi hai. You know, main serious devotee. You know, so Prabhupada was always very jolly, you know, and humorous at the same time, was very, very grave. During the last days, you know, devotees from New Brindavan, they brought for Prabhupada a ring, you know. They made a ring, very beautiful ring, and they gave to Prabhupada. This was during the last days. As Prabhupada got this ring, he said, oh, this is very nice ring. So where is the bride, you know? So that's how he was very jolly, you know. So one devotee told Prabhupada, Swamiji, you are looking very nice today. Prabhupada said, just today, you know. So that's how he was always, you know, in a jolly mood. One lady got up in the middle of the class and said, Swamiji, I want to marry you. You know. So Prabhupada said, thank you very much. But my dear daughter, I have already given my life to Krishna. And, you know, I cannot marry you. You know. So you chant Hare Krishna and be happy. You know. So all these great devotees, they are very jolly. At the same time, very, very serious and sincere and eager to practice bhakti. You know. Just like Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, when they go to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they beg, you know. They are expressing their heartfelt prayers. Nicha jati, nicha sangi kori, nicha kaj, tomar agrete prabhu kahite vasilaj. We are from a low class family. We are associating with low people. Kori nicha kaj. We are doing all abominable work. Tomar agrete, we are feeling ashamed just to stand in front of you, you know. But पतित पावन हेतु तोमावतार आमाबाई जगते पतित नहियार. You have appeared in this world to deliver the fallen. We are the most fallen. Please show your mercy to us first. You know. And then they say, you know what? Jagaya Madhaya was very, you know, great devotee. They were great people. They say, Jagaya Madhaya dui korila uddhar, taha uddharile shram nahila tomar. To deliver them, you didn't have to struggle. Why you didn't have to struggle? Because they had many good qualities, you know. What were the qualities Jagaya Madhaya had? You may be thinking, kya gun te yaar? Kuch bhi achche gun nahi te unme. So Rup Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, they were seeing good in Jagaya Madhaya also. What was the good quality? Brahman jati tar navadvipe ghar, niche seva nahi kore nahe niche rakur par. Are, they were born in Brahmana family. You know, they had their home in Navadvipa. They never served Malecha and Yavana. They had only one fault, you know. Sabe ek doshtar hai papachar, paparashi dahe nama bhasei tomar. They had only one fault. Thoda paap kiya. They looted somebody, raped few, you know. They killed. Thoda sa kuch, you know. Paparashi dahe, you know. The wholesale paap can be delivered by and burnt by your name. And how did they take their name? Toma naam laiya tomara korila nindan, sei naam haila tara mukti ra karan. They made fun of you, they criticized you. Oh Nimai, you are so nice, you know, you are also chanting nicely. They would make fun of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That name became the cause of their deliverance, you know. So, and they say, we are most fallen, you know. We have no hope. Only hope is your mercy, you know. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, you know, seeing your mercy, my heart is breaking, you know. Yeah, seeing your humility, my heart is breaking, you know. So that's why they were showing all their eagerness. We want your mercy, oh my Lord. So as Prabhupada writes in the Nectar of Instruction, the definition of enthusiasm. Enthusiasm means endeavor executed with intelligence, you know. So we have to be eager, enthusiastic. At the same time, we have to be intelligent enough, you know. We don't have to lose our brain. One devotee was driving Prabhupada and he was driving very fast. So Prabhupada told him, drive slowly. So he said, Srila Prabhupada, we have Narasimha Dev with us. Prabhupada said, but, you know, he won't protect above 60 km per hour, you know. So we have to be intelligent enough. You know, one devotee asked Prabhupada, Prabhupada, let's say there are two devotees, one gets the mercy of the Lord and becomes devotee and other does not get, although both are equally unqualified. What makes one devotee qualified for getting mercy and other not? Prabhupada said, don't try to find the formula for causeless mercy. You know, it is up to the giver. You have to struggle and endeavor yourself to become strong in bhakti, you know. So you have to be eager, hear about devotees, you know, and we have to be committed, you know, make commitments, you know, we have to take few sankalpa that I want it and how I will do it. We have to have that, you know, all the jotted down. How I will progress in bhakti, we should have some measurable goals also, you know. Just like in your college days and in the office, we have some, you know, deadlines. Ye syllabus itne time mein khatam karna hi hai, ye project hai, I have to finish in this much time. So in the bhakti also, it is not all vague and abstract. We have to make our, you know, deadlines to read Bhagavatam, to chant more whenever possible. I'll read Bhagavatam, I'll finish Bhagavatam, complete Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita. We have to be eager. We have to make commitments, we have to make deadlines, you know. Because if we are not committed, if we are not making any deadlines, if we are not making any, you know, schedule, then mind will convince us, bahut bhakti kar raha hai, you know. Slow down, you know. Bahut samay hai, you know. Why so hurry, you know? So we have to have, you know, Radhesham Prabhu, you know, he has his whole year's schedule ready, you know, and all the, you know, senior devotees, and they have no time. They have made themselves busy, you know. so busy that there is no time for Maya. You know. So we have to fill our day, fill our week, month and year with things about Krishna. You know. In that way we'll also advance in bhakti. You know. So that's how we discussed how we have to be eager. And if we are not eager, you know, we'll not get that Krishna prema. And to be eager, we have to hear from devotees, hear about devotees, make commitments, and we should have some measurable goals, and we should avoid the distractions in this age. Because nowadays, the distractions are very, very dangerous things, social media and all these things. So we have to be really focused, so that we will also get this Krishna bhakti rasa one day. You know. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Shrila Prabhupada ki jai, Granth Rashi Mad Bhagavatam ki jai.